बस अभी ये कंटिन्यू करो, वो बाद में लिखूंगा।
स्टार्टेड।
ओके, सी है वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थियरी कॉन्सेप्ट। इफ यू मिस्ड यस्टरडेस क्लास, नथिंग टू वरी, यू विल अंडरस्टैंड एवरीथिंग। इट्स ऑल इंडिपेंडेंट कॉन्सेप्ट ओनली, सो जस्ट बिलीव मी दैट। सो दिस व्हाट यू आर डूइंग हियर इज, इफ यू कंबाइन लेंसेस एंड मिरर्स इन वेरियस कॉम्बिनेशंस, यू कैन कम अप विद एक्सपेरिमेंट्स बाय डूइंग विच यू कैन फाइंड आउट द फोकल लेंथ ऑफ अ लेंस और अ मिरर डिपेंडिंग ऑन द वे यू कंबाइन देम। Okay, so your typical board exam, IC practical, dealing with light will have this situation only. Combining a lens and mirror and asking you to find the focal length of a lens or a mirror. Okay, so now let's see. So in your syllabus, these three cases are there. So I'll tell you how to understand them. Find the focal length of, one option is concave lens, other option is convex mirror. So you could be asked to find the focal length of a concave lens or a convex mirror using a combination of lenses and mirrors. So if you want to find the focal length of a concave lens, there are two possibilities. You could find it using a concave mirror or you could find it using a plane mirror. Okay, so today we will do this situation. Okay, if I finish it quickly, in the remaining time together we will figure out these two. Still a bit confusing. Okay, so then the next option is how to find the focal length of a convex mirror by using one convex lens in combination with it. Okay, so now let us see how to do this first case, finding focal length of concave lens using a concave mirror. So the way you do the experiment is, please go and sit there, everybody is getting disturbed. Okay, so let's draw the principal axis. Let's draw the principal axis. Now step one is, you will on the optical bench position the concave mirror. So let us say this is the concave mirror. So step one is fix it. So fix the position of concave mirror. So you will know the position of this concave mirror. Okay. Now this concave mirror will have a certain center of curvature. It is part of a circle, a spherical surface. So let us say this is the center of curvature of this concave mirror. So the property of a concave mirror is such that if the object is at center of curvature, which is twice the focal length, image will also be at center of curvature. This you know, right? If object is at 2f, image will be at 2f. So what you will do first is, take your object pin, let us say it's a red tipped pin, and keep it at the center of curvature. So how will you know? You won't know which is center of curvature. So what you do is, you remove parallax. So if you keep the pin here, and if you look from this side, you see from this side, if you move this pin back and forth and move your head sideways like this, you will see the inverted image of this pin like this, and the parallax should be removed. So if you remove, that means the inverted image and the object pin are at the same location, which means you have correctly identified the center of curvature of the concave mirror. Understood? So far. Yes, it's two in one. Theory is also covered, practical experiment is also covered. It will be one of the practical experiments in future. You have 7 experiments at light, right? It will be one of those. So note down this position. So this position has to be noted down. So this will give you from the pole of the mirror to here is radius of curvature of mirror. Rm equals radius of curvature of concave mirror. This you can find out in this way. You you know this position, you can measure this object field position and you can find out the radius. Next, now what you will do is, you will take the given concave lens whose focal length you need to find out. Find the focal length of this concave lens. So what you will do is, you will take the concave lens, place it in between this object field and this mirror. Understood this step? Step 2 is, once you find out the radius of the curvature of the concave mirror, you will take that concave lens, place it in between these two. Anywhere you can place. It's not a problem. Now to make you understand what is going to happen, I need to try a concave lens. So now if it is here, let us say the tip of the pin, it emits rays like this. Shorin will tell me, if an incident ray is emitted by the tip of the pin, how will the reflected ray be? Which direction will it go? The person I asked will tell. From the tip of the pin, which is at center of curvature, the incident ray came like this, hit the mirror. How will the reflected ray move?
It's supposed to go undeviated.
So undeviated means how it
is? As in it will go
British. Exactly, very good. It will come back the same way. This is the key feature. So whatever incident ray you give.
That happens when it passes the optical center.
Optical center, now here it is part. Listen, the principal axis is perpendicular to the mirror surface at optic center or at the pole of the mirror. So this is radius of the circle. So radius is perpendicular to the tangent at every point of the circle. So at every point, the surface is like a plane mirror, tiny plane mirror. So it's perpendicular. Are you getting it? That is the specialty of center of curvature point. Any ray coming from center of curvature will come back the same way.
That's for
spherical mirrors.
Mirrors and lenses. Good.
Not for lenses. It is for mirrors, spherical mirrors. Because this is like angle of incidence becomes zero in this case. Because this is the normal. The incident ray is along the normal. So angle of incidence is 0, so angle of reflection is 0, so it will come back the same way. So all the rays are going like this only. So if I take one more ray below, if it goes like this, it will also come back the same way.
Where's the concave lens?
Wait, I haven't kept any concave lens right now. Without concave lens, this is what is happening. The ray is coming back like this.
Okay.
Now I am going to place the concave lens. This is where it is a bit difficult to understand. So think very alert. So I am placing now, I am placing a concave lens in between, so things will change. So try to think and understand what will change, how it will change. So let us say I am keeping it here. Like this. Okay? So the concave lens is like this. Now, obviously, if the object pin continues to remain here, the moment these incident rays pass through the concave lens, they will converge or diverge?
Diverge.
The crucial point you are looking out the window. Look here. Incident rays will diverge.
Yes.
So instead of going like this, they will go like this.
Yes.
And if they go and hit the mirror here, will they retrace the same way?
No.
They will not. They will go somewhere else. They will be lost. This image will disappear. The moment you keep the concave lens, this parallax which you removed will be gone. The image will go somewhere else. It will go out of place. So again you will start seeing parallax between the image and the object of this pin. Right? So now what you need to do is, if this ray is going to get diverged like this, okay, you have to move. So what is happening is, if the incident ray makes this much angle, it is going to get diverged like this. Let us say. Okay. So if you reduce the angle of incidence, it will come out in this direction. Do you understand this important point?
No.
If the incident ray is like this, after refraction it will go like this. It will refract and go away, it will diverge. So instead, if I make the incident ray like this, then after refraction it will come like this. Are you getting it? Yes, so the angle of the incidence I have to decrease.
Yeah.
Then it will come out in this way.
On this
If it comes out in this way, it will again come back the same way. Because any wave which hits along this direction is a normal incidence at this point, it will come back the same way. Do you get this point? Think a little bit. What I am saying is, if a ray comes along this direction or along this direction, it will come back the same way because the mirror will behave in the same way. Yeah.
Coming back, is it because of the direction, or is it because it's coming from the center of curvature and not touching the
body? Listen, the direction from center of curvature to the mirror represents normal incidence.
Yes.
Which means angle of incidence is zero.
Yes.
So any incident ray which hits along this direction, it hits the plane, which hits the concave mirror, it will come back the same way.
Basically, our incidence has an angle so that the refracted ray is normal.
Yes. Yes. So, right now with this incidence, if I put a concave mirror, it will go up. So, I have to move the object pin back so that this incident ray will now come like this. That will come out in this way.
So, do we move the object back or we reduce the...
You will move the object back.
We can't just reduce that ray.
How can you? Rays are emitted in all directions. If I move the object back, so now I will erase this and modify it, okay? So this is
the side way better.
So should I draw a new diagram?
Yeah. Yes. So compare.
Okay, this is
old.
This is part one. Now for part two. So for part two, what you will do is, shift the object pin away from concave mirror to decrease angle of incidence. So, for example, if this is the concave mirror, if this is the center of the curvature, if this is the concave lens, now the object pin will be somewhere here. New position. So now for this new position, see how I am drawing, this is a crucial step. From the center of curvature, I am drawing the ray. Did you see this step? From the center of curvature, I drew the refracted ray. So from this new position, the incident ray will go like this. This is the crucial step to understand. If the incident ray goes in this direction, then after refraction by the concave lens, it will come according to as if, it will come as if it is appearing from center of curvature. Any ray which hits the concave mirror as if it is appearing from center of curvature will come back the same way towards the center of curvature. Are you getting it? So now any ray which is going towards central direction, now it will again come back the same way. That's what I investigated. So now what happens is, this incident ray represents this virtual object. So this incident ray represents the virtual object. So now you have the object distance as so now, from here to here. So this becomes your object distance u.
U prime, huh?
No. For this concave lens, okay, this is the incident ray for this concave, this is the, yeah, वेट ए सेकंड
यू प्राइम होगा यू तो स्टार्टिंग वाला
ओके 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 सी हियर दिस वे गोस एंड देन इट कम्स लाइक दिस राइट So this becomes the incident ray.
How?
So this blue arrow becomes the incident ray. And so this blue arrow appears to come towards this point. Agreed?
Yes. Appears.
So this is the point which is the virtual object. So the virtual object is at a distance of u. Correct only. Virtual object is at a distance of u from the concave lens, optic center of the concave lens. So this is the object distance and the refracted ray. So this is the incident ray. The blue ray is the incident ray. Let me write this.
It's the original.
Let me write this. Incident ray.
Original object.
Of virtual object. Okay. So this blue ray is representing the virtual object which is here. And the refracted ray represents the image. So, your position of object.
Wait.
Yes, ma'am.
So, जो आप ये blue वाला replace.
So the image.
That's the refracted ray, right?
Oh, listen.
This is a light.
This blue arrow represents the incident ray for the concave lens. For the concave lens, this blue arrow is the incident ray. Which undergoes refraction and comes back like this. This is the refracted ray.
But the virtual object bana tab
left jaati hai right jaati hai to sir
in this case it is going like this.
Aur jab light jaati to
while going right this was the incident ray this was the real object
yes
and this will be the virtual image.
But the virtual image banaya because of the refracted ray of the new object of the original object.
See, you can interpret, you can do it in two ways. Yes. We'll discuss it. Right now, we consider this as the incident ray. Yeah. This is the object distance.
Then what, sir?
And then when it comes back, this becomes the image distance. Okay, so let us see. Sir. Let us see in both ways. It should be the same answer. 1 minute, let me finish and then we'll discuss again. That's why I say it's a bit confusing. This is one option. This is option one. But if you think this is the real object, okay, Nikun? You are saying this is the real object. Then if this red arrow is the incident ray, then this distance is object distance. Let us call this U1, V1, this is U2. So this is the object distance U2. Then this will be the image distance V2.
So we are assuming that U1 is
what is.
Okay.
Agreed?
Option 2 samajh aa gaya, option 1 ignore
ho gaya. Okay, let us see in your book which option you have taken. No. See it? LO is U.
Options for what?
LO. We have taken option 1 in the book. So we can go with option 2, both should give the same answer. See, with respect to incident ray, if this is incident ray, this is going to be positive.
But usually,
we take object to be equivalent. See, the sign convention rule is any distance measured in the direction of incident ray is positive, any distance measured opposite to direction of incident ray is negative. So let's apply that sign convention.
Okay.
Your incident ray is this side.
Yeah.
So U2 is going to be negative in option 2. Agreed?
Yeah.
And V2 is also going to be negative. Okay? Yeah. Agreed? Now in option 1, the incident ray is like this.
Yeah.
So U1 is in the direction. So positive.
All them both positive.
V1 is also positive. Now, okay. Let's apply lens.
Why did you get my option 1 is positive?
What?
I didn't get my option 1 is positive.
See, in option 1, we took the reflected ray from the concave mirror as the incident ray for the lens.
Okay.
This incident ray represents a virtual object. Right. So, this object distance is in the direction of incident ray. So, it's plus plus. So now let us apply 1 by V minus 1 by U equals 1 by F. So let us give some values and see what happens. Let us say this distance is 5 centimeter. This distance is 10 centimeter. Numerical value. So let us see what happens when we substitute in option 1. In option 1, this is what the book has given. What happens? 1 by V is
1 by 10 minus 1 by 5.
So what which is?
Minus 1 by 5.
Solve it and tell me.
Minus 1 by 10.
Finally, F equals?
F is minus 10.
Minus 1 by 10.
F is 10.
Minus 10
is
minus 10.
Minus 10. Mm-hmm. Which is making sense?
Yeah.
Focal length of concave lens is supposed to be negative?
Yeah.
Okay, now let us do with option 2. 1 by V. V is?
Minus 5.
Minus 5. Minus 1 by U.
Minus
U is?
10.
Minus 10. 1 by F. Minus, minus, even plus. So it becomes 1 by 10 minus 1 by 5 equals 1 by F. So you'll get the same thing. Beautiful, no?
Very good.
Two different ways of looking at the same thing. Getting this. What's in the red? Up. ये दो केस अपना दिमाग लगा के फिगर करो मुझे अभी तो
लगा
तो फोकल लेंथ मिल गया ना तुम्हें बाय एक्सपेरिमेंट यू नो द पोजीशन ऑफ द लेंस यू नो द पोजीशन ऑफ दिस सेंटर ऑफ कर्वेचर बिकॉज दैट वाज अ पॉइंट वेयर द फर्स्ट फ्रॉम हियर यू नो द पोजीशन ऑफ सी नाउ यू मूव द पिन अगेन इफ द रे कम्स एंड फॉर्म द इमेज हियर यू विल गेट द इन्वर्टेड इमेज ऑफ द पिन अगेन So again you will remove parallax. Second time. Listen. Listen, listen. So you miss the point. Listen. Without concave lens, you remove parallax here. You got this position of object pin that gave you the radius RM. Okay. Now after keeping concave lens, you again move the pin back. Again the image will form like before.
If you remove the lens.
You won't remove the lens. Keeping the lens there, if you move the pin back, again the rays will retrace the same path and come back.
Yes.
That means again you will get the image at the same location as the object.
Yes.
So second time you will remove parallax here. So this new position is the image position. Say capital I if you call it.
This was supposed to be the old position.
In option 1, this is called the new image position.
Yeah.
Okay. This position also you will note down. Are you getting it? So if you note this down, now you want to know V. So lens position you have noted down in your record. This new pin position you have noted down in your record. This minus this will give you V. And C minus lens will give you U. Then you use 1 by V minus 1 by U to find 1 by F.
Yes.
Understood?
Yes.
Clear? Wasn't it amazing?
Amazing. Amazing.
Now, using this knowledge, try to understand how they have used a plane mirror to find focal length of concave lens and how they have used convex lens to find focal length of convex mirror. Great. Look at the book. I will also try. Stop the recording.